Morning, everyone. Coming at you again from my backyard, surrounded by all my chicken friends that you'll be seeing in just a moment here. Hope you're not getting bored by all these talks coming from our backyard. You know, if you are, I'm sure you can find reruns of Lassie or Gilligan's Island somewhere on the internet or Netflix. Well, I guess I just dated myself, didn't I? Well, I wasn't able to upload my Sunday service today. This is the fifth Sunday in Lent, but it is an important Sunday, and I wanted to say a few more words about the gospel lesson for today. Just briefly, it's a story about Jesus' good friend Lazarus, who died. Jesus had been sent word that he was sick. He took his time getting there. By the time he did, his sisters, Lazarus' sisters, are yelling at him, "Why weren't you here, Lord? He would not have died if you had been here, because God will give you whatever you want," and all this, that, and the other. And people are moaning and groaning and weeping. And the story ends, as we all know, with Jesus going to the tomb, shouting to Lazarus, "Come out of there, Lazarus!" He does, and he's alive again. But what is this story all about? Well, let's just talk a little bit about these friends of mine, these feathered friends, also those furry friends back there. I'll walk back there so you can get a closer look at them. You haven't really seen the goats in all their glory. There they are, sneaking off now. They're munching, kind of hanging around, having a good time. One thing that you quickly learn when you have farm animals, and those of you who do know this, not only do you deal with the good stuff, the fun stuff, the baby chicks, the baby goats, this, that, and the other, you also have to deal with death. Right here are our rabbit hutches. We've had plenty of rabbits in the past. We don't anymore. We've either given them away or they have up and died. We now use these as our chicken hospitals to give them some social distancing if they need so, if they're sick. There's one just hopped in there on his own. But yes, it is true. When you raise animals, you're going to deal a lot with death. This tree, I'm going to swing around here. See that tree right there behind me? Beautiful, beautiful maple tree, gives us lots of shade. One day, I was feeding the chickens underneath this tree, and out down from the sky swoops a hawk, lands on this branch right over my head here. Scared me, scared the chickens. They all ran for cover back into the coops. He was looking for a meal, looking for a bird to eat. There was a day that my wife Janice and my one daughter were sitting outside, and right in front of them, out of nowhere, came a fox, grabbed the chicken, off it went. There's a lot of unpleasant things you have to put up with, as well as the fun things as well. We are on the farm, surrounded by life, abundant life, but also death. It's a reality. And so that's the position that Mary and Martha found themselves in. And in the Gospel of John, it's a gospel that's often called the Book of Signs, in which the stories about Jesus and his words are carefully crafted together by the gospel writer John in such a way that we're constantly pointing not only toward death, but beyond death, to life. And that's what the story of Lazarus is all about. The story in which Jesus said, "I am resurrection, I am life." There's so much more than just these years that we spend here on this earth. As important as they are, as vital as they are, as awesome as they can be. And I think that's what he was trying to tell them in our lesson for today, that this is a beautiful life. I have come to give you life and to give you it abundantly, not only now, but also in the future. One of the things that the gospel writer John does is he puts the words together so beautifully that they take on different meanings for different people at different times. One of the things that I like deals with the end of the story when Lazarus walks out of the tomb and he's still wrapped up like a mummy. He's still shuffling along, coming out, and everyone is, I can just imagine their jaws are dropping. What's going on here? And Jesus says, just don't stand there looking at him. Unbind him. We didn't exactly say it that way, but unbind him. Unbind him. We have a part in this beautiful thing called life. We have a part in being resurrected from our tombs, our figurative tombs here on this earth. Jesus will take care of the literal tomb later on. But for now, we are people who are bound up by fear, bound up by uncertainty, bound up by feeling isolated, alone. That's what these days are all about right now. But we can put our hopes, we can rest assured that who Jesus says he is, he will be for us here and right now. And what does he say to us today? I am resurrection. I am life. Now, get out there and go unbind each other. God's blessings be with you in the coming days.